beyond what's shown in the React 3 Fiber documentation, which is declaring the module after importing from 3 WebGPU, we're extending this so that it has the new capabilities. And I've added the WebGPU is available check. So this is imported from the capabilities util. For now, it's just returning null. Obviously, this isn't kind of suitable for a real project at the moment because it's only Chrome that has WebGPU support, I believe. So anyway, we've got the canvas set up. Now, I've set up a basic page which has the canvas. It's got some lights and there's an interactive sphere. So what we're going to be looking at here is using 3.js shading language, and in particular the node materials, extending the node material. So one of the main kind of benefits of TSL is that it massively removes complexity around extending existing shaders. So previously we would have to inject a GLSL string into another existing shader, which would be done on using the on before compile or on compile, or we use the package custom shader material, something like that. But both of those are fairly clunky and quite error prone. So this really is going to be the future, I think, for 3.js shader development, because it's render agnostic, so it can output to WebGL and WebGPU. It's written in JavaScript, so it's going to be easier for people to pick up. And there's just a lot less code to do the same thing. So let's dive into it and see how we can get this sphere animating using the TSL. I've got the components set up, got a sphere which is imported from Dre, given it some size. There's now a mesh fong node material, so X material can be replaced by X node material, and then we can attach different nodes to it. So depending on the material, there'll be a number of different nodes which can be overridden. In this case, we're just looking at the color and the position. When the pointer enters, we're setting our state value to true or false as it leaves. So we've captured that up here. Now, this block of code inside the use memo is where the data for the shader is being prepared and returned. I've defined the uniform for the uHovered. It's not actually a Boolean, so it's not u is hovered, it's just hovered, so its value will range between 0 and 1, or between whatever we want, but 0 and 1 is useful for mixing. So we then create a couple of color gradients, and these are nice and easy to make. We can see changing those updates that. So the two sets of gradients which are being mixed vertically using the Y value. So at the bottom, we have this color. So this would be blue, where Y is 0, and then red when Y is 1 right at the top. And then we are creating our color node by mixing the base cut, the default color of the hovered color based on the hovered value, which will move between 0 and 1, so the colors will animate smoothly between those two. And what's cool is you'll notice that the lighting is preserved, so we can see kind of some of the light coming through. Same with shadows. And that's been achieved with literally about 10 lines of code, if you ignore the comments. The position node works in the same way. We're actually using an imported variable from 3TSL, which gives us access to the world position of the sphere. And then with that, we can just subtract or add or multiply, do whatever transformation to that. And in this case, I'm just subtracting a vector 3 for the x, y, and z, where we're again passing in the u hovered value. So at the moment, it's moving towards us. I can change that and it'll move away from us. In order to actually update the uniform, we are passing that out along with the nodes into the use frame using the damping method from mathutils, which is from 3. And when the pointer is over, it will move towards 1. And when it's not over, it will move back to 0. That creates this smooth animation with both the nodes applied down here along with the key. So the key is just a value on the color node. So whenever this changes, it will trigger, I think it's a recompilation of this material. But in this case, that won't happen because our use memo has no dependencies. This will just be set up once. I mean, some of this could potentially be extracted out of here. I'm not sure if that would work, but either way, pretty cool. And yeah, nice and simple. I'm going to look into some more advanced topics, particles, instances, more complicated animations, that type of thing, all within the React 3 Fiber TSL kind of niche. So if that's something that you're interested in, please consider subscribing, and hope to see you in the next one. I forgot to say, the code for this project is on my GitHub account, so I'll link to this repo down below, so you can come in and have a look at what we just did together here. Cool. Bye.